This is an oral history interview conducted for the Witness to War Serving a Nation project at Nauset Regional High School on Cape Cod, Massachusetts. For the sake of this interview, please state your name, please state your full name and community in which you now reside.
Hubert Howard Heath, Jr. It's in the Cumberquid area of Cape Cod.
Okay. We'll start off with your early life. Where did you grow up?
In Needham, Massachusetts.
When did you get interested in the military?
When the war broke out, I enlisted.
You weren't drafted?
No.
Why did you choose the Army instead of, say, the Air Force?
My eyes. They wouldn't take me. Air Force wouldn't take me.
What did you do for work before the war?
Oh, let me see. Oh, I was a student at Northeastern, and do you mean real young, when you're real young? I used to be in the building.
How old were you when you enlisted?
20, 21.
Did you have a job right before you enlisted?
No, I was in school. Oh. I enlisted in the there's a reserve corps. I can't think of the other name. Enlisted Reserve Corps. So I could, I went to Northeastern for about one semester, and then they called us up. And we went to, from everybody in my, in that particular area, they all went to Fort Devens first.
If you can remember, when did people around you, just in your everyday life, start to notice the Nazi rise to power as bad?
When did they notice it?
Yeah.
Right from the very beginning. As soon as the Nazis started marching, that was in 39, and the British had a tough time. they were driven out of France, and were able to get back to England, some of them. But the Germans just marched all over Europe, or were about to, and the United States finally got into the war. That's that's all I can remember.
Did you have any reasons specifically for why you joined the Army?
Oh, definitely. I wanted to join. I would have been drafted anyway. So I enlisted.
Where did you train?
Fort Devens. We went from Fort Devens to Keesler Field, Mississippi. That's where I did my basic training, Keesler Field. That was in Biloxi, Mississippi. And then that's where all the basic training was done.
What was the training like?
Physical fitness. A lot of marching, a lot of exercises, a lot of climbing over different contraptions, and crawling on your belly, and target practice.
(Clears throat) Your son tells me that you were a private, a first class, a quartermaster. Can you explain to me what those are?
Private first class, yeah. That's what I am. Not a private, private first class.
Could you explain what that is?
I don't think I could. It's one grade below a corporal.
What's a corporal?
A corporal is, boy, those are good questions. I never really thought of it. There's a corporal, and there's a sergeant, and there's a staff sergeant, a technical sergeant, and a first sergeant on the enlisted men group. What it meant? I guess it's just a beginning rank for a soldier, that's all.
What was the first major event that happened in the war when you got out of training?
The first major event? You mean worldwide or personal?
Either.
Well, the first thing I remember, after basic training, we went to Salt Lake City, Utah, and then from there we went down to Clovis, New Mexico. I was right on the Texas line. There, they had B-24 heavy bombardment practice flights, just skimming over the desert, low flights. And anyway, from there, we went down to, like I say, Clovis, New Mexico. After that, they had a bulletin on the wall for anyone interested in training for training for landing barges on the beaches. They wanted people to train for that. So three or four of us joined. We signed up for it. And we thought we were going to go and get training for that. But we ended up in Fort Lee, New Jersey, and they shipped us overseas right away. Well, we were in shock. But anyway, we went over in 1940, October of 1943. We left New York on convoy and ended up in Scotland. And then from Scotland, we went down into England, and I ended up at a reception depot for fighter pilots. They had P-51 pilots, and the P-38 pilots, and there was one other. But this was just a reception depot where they all got together and got their equipment before they shipped off to an air base. They had air bases scattered all over the place in England. And the fighter pilots were escorted the heavy bombers when they went on their tour of duty. when they went on bombing missions over Germany and France. Well, that was about it. I mean, the shocker was that we were going overseas. I think that was the big thing. But I ended up in a town called Stone. That's the Midlands in England. And I was stationed there until we embarked on going home. And we went home through France. Why? I don't know. Because the war was over. But we left Le Havre, France, to come back to the States.
What was the hardest time during your enlistment?
The hardest time? I don't think there was ever any hard time. If I was in the infantry, I probably could have told you plenty. But I wasn't. I was in supply, quartermaster. Clothing and equipment like that.
Do you have a fond memory from your time overseas?
I didn't hear you.
Do you have a fond memory from your time overseas or in training?
Oh, yes. I met my wife.
In training or overseas?
In England.
In England.
She was a nurse. And we got married over there. Iris. Her name was Iris. She passed away in 09. 2009. But anyway, that was the nicest part.
Do you have any memory of where you were during the Pearl Harbor attack?
Pearl Harbor, no, I was home. I hadn't gone into the service yet. That happened in 1941, so. I don't recall where I was. I was probably in school, I know that. I was probably still in high school, actually, in 41.
Do you remember where you were during D-Day?
I was in England. There was a lot of activity all over the place, and a lot of praying. A lot of activity. Airplanes everywhere. And of course, we weren't involved in the, D-Day, our group. But everyone was, you know, talking and very concerned about the situation, because a lot of men were going to meet their end, that's for sure, when they went up on the beaches in Normandy. But no, I was in England. The whole group was in England. But that's where they launched all the amphibious boats. I don't know, they had an awful lot of boats going out, and landing barges, and a lot of miserable situations for the guys that had to land there.
Do you have any memorable moments with a soldier on the other side?
I've heard stories. A good friend of mine, he was a neighbor of mine. He was in special forces and he was in the infantry. And I found out through him that they got pinned down in Anzio in Italy when they did an invasion on the western shore of Italy. There's two places, Anzio and one other. But he got hit. The Germans overrun the beach. And he was captured, but he was seriously wounded. But this German doctor took very good care of him and actually saved his life. And that's about it.
Could you tell me about your group?
My group?
You keep referring to we as like, who is with you?
Oh, we had several people involved in the quartermaster, taking care of clothing and equipment. I remember one fellow from Brooklyn. Well, most of them were from down south. Most of them were from down south. I was actually in a rebel outfit. They were still fighting the war, the Civil War, I think. But anyway, no, that's, I can't remember all of the fellas that were there. I can remember Jimmy Horn. Guy named Casey. He couldn't stop drinking, the poor soul. He ended up in the dispensary. Well, that's about it.
What did you do during your downtime?
Oh, I used to do artwork for the gunner's jackets.
Oh, the gunner's jackets?
Yeah. I used to paint whatever they wanted on the back of the jacket. Sometimes they just wanted bombs to show how many missions they were on. But other times they had a pretty girl they wanted on there, or different things. But anyway, I enjoyed doing that. And we always had, every now and then in the course of a day at this reception depot, we would have some hotshot pilots, fighter pilots. They would buzz the place in the P-51s and the P-38s. And there's another one. Can't think of what the number is, but they were always buzzing us, and occasionally one would crash, which was too bad. They'd have hit the high tension wires or something like that around our base. I think I'm remembering everything. I'm not absolutely sure. But that's about it, I think.
What was the first thing you did when you got home?
Wow. Well, we celebrated, that's for sure. I really don't know. Well, we were just wondering what was laying ahead for us. We had to go back to school again. Or find a job. You know, the usual routine for after being away so long. You wondered what was, after the war was over, what was in store for everybody. We didn't know what to expect, but we were glad to be home.
Did your wife come home with you, or did you guys have to meet up after the war?
Iris came over after I did. After I came back, she came over on the George Washington liner. I met her in New York City. In fact, one of my sons was born in England. Bob, he's passed away too.
Did the war change how you saw people?
How I saw people? I don't think so. I know the Germans. Well, we used to see prisoners of war coming into England. And they were nothing but 12 or 13-year-old kids carrying a rifle. I couldn't get over that. They were just... well, they were captured. They were lucky they were captured, because they would have been nothing but gun fodder. And they, the Germans had stooped to the lowest. The war should have been over long before it ended, finally ended, because of Hitler and his crew. Because the destruction and
how did you get back on your feet after returning home?
Wow. I went to art school at St. Patel Street in Boston, Vesper George School of Art. And I started there and ended there. That's not, the school has gone by, and it's not around anymore, but it was on St. Patel Street in the Back Bay.
Do you think anything like this could ever happen again?
That's a hard one to say. It depends upon how strong Mr. Trump wants to make our military. Right now, we're getting pushed around big time by a very weak group of people that are running this country. Or they got their own agendas, I don't know which. But a lot of tragedy has transpired under this administration that's not good for the world, in fact.
Are you glad that you served?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I would have felt bad if I didn't. Everybody went. Everybody joined up that could. I don't think mother and father were happy about it, but they couldn't do anything about it anyway. You get drafted, you gotta go. But I didn't get drafted, I enlisted.